It's got a nice right there.
Got a flawless. Are you kind of into it?
All I'm doing is stepping back and forth, but I see that character on screen looking awesome. Probably way cooler than I look. So there's this concept of an attentional spotlight where early on in an experience, you're really hyper-focused on just a little bit of what's going on in that game. You're not really paying attention to anything else. Over time, that spotlight starts to expand. You're able to see the entire experience. Same thing for like the boombox down there, the score. Even the same thing for you can see the little circle underneath the character. If I do the move right, you can see, I'm gonna try to get one right here. There, I kinda got one right. If I do it right, you can see I get some positive feedback, right? Even that stuff is stuff that people really weren't even seeing. And really understanding what the human attentional system is capable of seeing and hearing and coding is what helps us to design that initial experience. My name is Tim Nichols. I'm a user research lead at Microsoft Studios and the Studios user research team. Basically what that means is that my team and I, we conduct research on video games. And so specifically the research that we focus on are questions around how people play games, why they make the decisions that they make in games, why they do well in some games, why they don't do well in other games. And we try to answer really just any question related to how people interact with video games. The biggest thing that I do, the consistent thing that I do from day to day is I think about games, I talk to people about games. My team and I, we're always working with teams who are actually out there making games. And they have a lot of questions about how their game is being received by their target audience. And so frequently what that means is the folks on my team and myself, you know, we've got sort of a long history and a lot of experience in thinking about human behavior and specifically how human behavior relates to playing video games. And so what that means is that we talk to these teams about questions about how difficult a game is, whether people are learning how to play the game at the right pace, whether something's fun or not, and not just whether something's fun or not, but what is it that makes it fun? What is it that makes it not fun? And how can we kind of cut out some of that not fun stuff? So if I had to sum it up, on a day-to-day basis, the thing that I do is I talk about games and I talk about human psychology and human behavior in the context of games. So a lot of people ask me how they can get into a games user research job in the industry. And for me, the two big things are be passionate about research, be passionate about games. If you're a grad student right now, there's no reason why you can't combine those two passions and start doing research right now, even when you're in school, answering the kinds of questions that I answer on a daily basis.
It's going to be the same thing for a minute.
Yeah.